wonderful service prepared for you with our cantatas. We'll get to that in just a moment. We're going to be starting our service singing a hymn today. You'll find the hymn books in your pews. They're the blue books. Okay, so that's what we're going to be starting up with. Just a couple of quick announcements before we begin today. I just wanted to remind everyone that for those here at St. James that wanted to purchase poinsettias for Christmas, there's a sign-up sheet in the main hallway on the bulletin board, so today's the last day for that. So please do sign up and see Joy Taylor for information about payment on that. Advent letters from your wardens are available for you to take home. We'd ask you to do that after our service today. And also a reminder that we are going to be holding an Advent Bible study here at St. James with myself, Wednesday mornings at 10:30 through Advent. So if you'd like some information on that, feel free to see me. And we hope everyone will come upstairs for a time of fellowship and refreshment following our service today. So once again, welcome, and we're going to begin by singing our opening hymn, 114 in your blue hymnal, 114. I would ask the congregation to please stand.
Thank you.
wonderful to be together on such a festive day and occasion here at St. James. One of my favorite prayers of Jesus, of all the ones he did and all the ones he said, were the one that he prayed for God, that God's people would be as one. Because there's a wonderful power when Christians gather together in one body. The world gets transformed a little bit. It changes a little bit when we come together and we give glory to our Creator and glory to Jesus. So that's what we're doing today. We're coming together as one to offer glory, to sing together, to pray together, to hear words of Holy Scripture, and to prepare our hearts for the coming of Jesus at Christmas time. And the choir, the children, our readers of the parish, our parishioners and guests and family are all part of being one today. So that's what we're celebrating, and I hope you enjoy today. In your bulletin is an order of service. We're going to start with an opening prayer. And you'll see the collect printed there for the first Sunday of Advent. So I invite you to open your bulletins and join me as we pray this prayer together as one. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Now is the time of this mortal life, in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to us in great humility, that on the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty, to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life of the world, through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
ready for our welcome for the Son of God, Jesus the Messiah. And as we celebrate this joyful and holy season, we adorn this, his sanctuary, with symbols that reminds us of his birth, his life, his sacrificial death, and his triumphant resurrection. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. So, let the celebration begin.
Thank you. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who received him, to those who believed his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Jesus himself said, "Everyone who looks to the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life. I tell you the truth, he who believes has everlasting life."
You see, the Bible in the manger is also The babe in the manger is also the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. For centuries, the earth had longed for a Messiah, a Savior, one who would redeem and save. And then, just as the prophets had foretold, he came.
Sing. Candles and the light they display remind us that Jesus is the light of the world. He is the only true hope for our sin-darkened lives. In fact, light is the ideal metaphor for Christ. His presence, like even the tiniest candle flame, dispels the darkness and spills over into a dreary world. As we let the love of Christ shine through us, we illuminate all those we come in contact with. And just as a room full of candles produces a blazing glory, so when we join the light of other believers, we light up the world with the love of Christ.
Thank you.
Today we have celebrated the coming birth of Jesus Christ by singing the music of Christmas. We have adorned his sanctuary with symbols that remind us of him. Our prayer for each of you today is that his love, his life, and his light will be a very real part of your day-to-day living, not just at this holy season, but forever. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
And since you brought the bells, how about we throw them at the end of the song, too?
You're welcome.